Marie, go ahead. Say what you were saying now.
First of all, I want to tell you I love your show. And I first started watching you back in during COVID, but you just never popped up in my feed lately. So, enough said. But I was just trying to be the devil's advocate and just say, like, there's always unforeseen circumstances that can happen that are beyond people's control, and you can't always be that straight-minded, where you're not leaving leeway for those unforeseen things to happen, and just have that kind of mindset all the time. You have to have some kind of heart, especially with the things that you're talking about right
Let
now.
me
I mean,
ask
I'm
you
just
this.
saying.
Let me ask you this, Marie. You ever been homeless?
No, but
Why not?
I've known people.
Why?
I've
Why?
known
No, I'm
people,
talking about you. I'm talking
and
about
I've
you.
even known couples actually that
I'm
have said it,
talking
which I
about
thought
you,
I
though,
hadn't.
Esmarie. Have you ever been
No, not
homeless?
me.
Why not? Why?
What do you mean, why not?
Why do you think? No, I'm asking you because you've never been
That, what kind of
homeless.
question is that?
It's a question that I
There's
want you
that's
to
something
answer.
that has never happened to me. So I mean,
What's that?
but we're just talking about just
No, I'm
overall,
making a
like with
point.
in
Why haven't
general,
you ever been homeless?
you said a direct thing that people are that's their fault. And you can't think like
Okay, but
that.
you've never been homeless. You see, you're avoiding, you're tap dancing around my question. You
But
asked
I
me
know
what
people
kind of
who have.
question is that?
I know people who
It's a
have.
typical question. I wanted to know, have you ever been homeless? So when you said
No.
no, I asked you why. Why won't you answer me?
Because it's never happened. Thank
Okay,
God.
but why though? Because it happened to people. You know a couple that was homeless, right? Why hasn't it
It
happened to you?
happened, but there were unforeseen
Why
circumstances
hasn't
beyond
that
their
happened to
control.
you?
If people can get laid off, people,
Why hasn't it
a
happened
house
to
can
you?
burn up. I mean, there's all kinds of things in this
Okay,
world that
but
can
why
happen
hasn't
that are
that
out of
happened
our
to you?
control that can cause crazy things to happen.
You're not
You
even
know,
listening.
it's
You're
just
just
my
talking. You're
blessings, I
rambling on.
think, but at the end of the day, it could happen to anybody tomorrow.
You're
You know what I'm
rambling
saying? It could be an
on. You're
earthquake
not
and we all
addressing
lose
my
everything
question.
tomorrow. I'm just saying, you count your blessings every day, but at the end of the day, you can't have that thought process
Can you guys hear
to
me now?
not leave room, for
I hear you
unforeseen things.
perfectly fine. This is just an unruly woman at the
You're
moment.
just rambling on, sis. I
You're not
apologize.
addressing my questions. I'm trying to create some intelligent dialogue here because
I
you're
apologize.
not giving any kind of validity to what you're alleging. I'm showing you
Well,
that
yes,
if
I am.
someone ends up homeless, it's because somewhere in the equation, as an adult, they made bad decisions that led to that. You understand what I'm saying? They made bad decisions.
I
I'm not
can't,
on
I
the
mean, I
street.
agree with you, but I can't totally agree with you because,
I
I mean,
don't
people can
agree,
have
and I
an
don't care
accident,
whether
they
you
can
agree
become
with me.
disabled. I mean, things can happen that can
Show me how I'm
cause
wrong then.
things like that to happen. They cannot have a support group or help. I mean,
You don't
I'm
need
just
to show
saying there's a lot of
you as an adult,
unforeseen things that you have
you
to
as an adult
equate
are not
to
supposed,
not just,
you don't rely on no support group.
I'm sorry. Say
As
that
an
again.
adult, you don't rely on no support group.
Of course you don't, but all I'm saying is
That's unrealistic.
you're making a very direct statement
You're right.
with
I am.
it's like it's black and white, and there you're not leaving any leeway for the inevitable, and inevitables happen every day in our
Okay,
lives,
what's the inevitable? What's the inevitable?
I mean, accidents happen every day on the
Okay,
highway.
so no,
600 people
you're
die a
being
day on the
vague.
highway.
You're
That's not
being
something they
vague.
caused.
You're speaking from
No, I'm being
emotional
very real.
points.
I'm
I'm
being
speaking
very
from
real.
facts. Okay, so give me the
These are
inevitable.
facts.
Okay, so you haven't stated one fact. Give me the fact that
I
you're
stated a
allegedly
whole bunch
stating.
of them.
Give me this fact that you're
So
allegedly
nothing
stating.
I said was a fact for you?
No, you haven't said anything that was factual or emotional. Give
No,
me, you're
not
not even giving me
emotional.
one
I'm
instance
being
yet.
real.
You just
Realization
said
is
that.
things that can happen every day and that does
Okay,
happen every
give me
day
an
to all
example.
of us.
Give me
As
some
people, I
examples
just
of these
told you,
things.
somebody being disabled, somebody having a car
Give
accident,
me an
somebody
example
having
of some of
death in
these
the
things.
family. I mean, are you listening? I'm giving
No,
you
no,
all
no, no.
examples. These are all examples.
Because you're just rambling it off.
I'm not. I'm giving you
Give me the
examples of
example.
things that can happen that can cause people to be homeless.
Okay, so then name them.
I just named them. Did you
No,
not
I
hear
didn't
me?
hear it. Name them again.
Okay, so just like in my comments, I said somebody could become disabled. There could be a car accident. The house could caught on fire. Their loved one or husband or whoever could die, death in the family. I mean, they could get fired from their job. I mean, like, unforeseen things happen.
Stop. How many people, what you're giving is unrealistic, right?
Now, realistic.
Let me address
very realistic. Those. You cannot eliminate or not overlook those things and not equate them to what you said. I hear you. I'm going to be quiet.
And allow me to address those.
Sure.
First of all, if someone becomes disabled, how many people that you know that became homeless as a result of being disabled?
There are lots of people out there.
How many do you know?
If you are a grown adult and you don't have no support system, no family, and you become disabled, you're probably going to end up.
She's too emotional. You see what I'm saying? She's not addressing one point. She's making a lot of just blind statements out of emotions with no facts. Here's a point, right? Someone loses their job, right? If you lost your job, the reason that you end up homeless is because you was an irresponsible adult and then you didn't plan for that. You didn't plan for it. If your house burned down, you was a damn loser that didn't have insurance on your house. So you end up homeless. If you end up disabled, you was irresponsible and did not have life insurance to take care of situations like that. So she hasn't named one thing that justifies an adult being homeless. Sure, things happen, but if we plan for those, if we prepare for those, then we should at least be able to sustain something for a certain period of time instead of being on the streets. But when I see a woman with three children on the streets, I don't feel sorry for her. That's bad decision making. That's her bad decision making. She got with bad men. Now she's blaming them, but what part of that equation is she responsible for in that? And the decision of getting with men like that and putting children through stuff like that. You see what I'm saying? You see how Eve is? She didn't want to address. She says, I'm giving facts. What facts did she give?
Yes.
All emotions. All emotions. Every single one of those scenarios, I could tell you how, because listen, we're not taught to conduct ourselves as responsible adults as we should, right? If we know, listen, man, this is what I tell people about a 9-to-5. Yeah, you damn right you could lose your job. You could lose it tomorrow. So that means that there's no security in that, right? So you're supposed to be planning for things like that. And in the event that something like that takes place, if I know that I'm working a job or I could go out here and get injured in a car, someone run into me, I don't plan it. If I don't have insurance, you're damn right, I'm going to end up homeless. I could end up homeless, but is that something that I could avoid it? Maybe not the accident. But
some people can't afford insurance.
Security. I could have had some
form
of
security. Some people cannot afford insurance, sweetheart. I'm just saying, like, I'm trying to be the devil's advocate and just
You are the devil. You coming back and talk on me, man. I'll leave it out there, man. Well, what do you guys think about that?
So, you absolutely correct. I mean, if you work in 9-to-5, you can lose your job at any moment. That's literally just, you know, what it is. You need to plan appropriately. If you fail to plan, you know, you're planning to fail. So you can count on it. And just because things are going the way you may want them to for a period of time, that's ultimately still within your control, the end results. So it's our responsibility. If someone ends up homeless, it's their responsibility. Any one of us happens, it's our responsibility.
We fail to make an appropriate decision. And so what happens from that is called the consequences. Do you think Donald Trump would end up homeless? Why? See, she hasn't even been homeless, right? Because she knows how to make decisions to make sure that doesn't happen to her. And she knew that's the point I was going towards. So those people that this happened to, sure, things happen. I've been in those situations, but I've been homeless. But it was my decision. It was my decision to walk away from two jobs. But, and then I stood on that. I didn't go back and say, I'm going to work back in the system. But when you fall homeless and you got children, I got way more empathy for the children than, you know, this woman making bad decision. Three different baby fathers. Now you blaming them because of your predicament. Come on, man. What's your thought on that, Kadar?
I agree with you 100%. It all starts in, you know, your decision-making. It starts and ends in your decision-making. Because you should be thinking, as a mother with three children, whatever the situation is with their father, if it didn't work out, whatever the case is, you know that those children are your responsibility. You ought to provide for them. So if you end up in a situation where you don't have nowhere for them kids to stay, that's a result of your bad decision making. So therefore, her lesson would be out of this situation to make better decisions, you know, and put herself in a better position and make a better decision in the men that you chose to deal with that give a sin about their children or whatever the case is. So at the end of the day,
and now she act like CPS shouldn't be coming after her. Look at the predicament you have your children in.
That's the accountability part that Eve, she lacked that accountability.
Listen, man.
I mean, you know, I can't really. Can I say something?
Go ahead.
I can't really speak on the situation because no one knows what led to whatever this person's situation is, right? But I'll give an example. I just want to give one example, and it may not pertain to this, but all I'm saying is I met a guy, this was years ago when I was younger, and he said to me, he was just like, I had a situation, and he was like, man, get out there and hustle. And to me, I was like, hustle? What's hustle? Like I didn't know what hustle was because I wasn't raised in an environment where I learned or knew nothing about hustling. I know people talk about it on TV and in the movies, but had I ever had to do it myself? No. So did I know how to hustle? No. And so it was foreign language to me to get out there and do that. But, you know, I got his point, you know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, you know, maybe she just don't know. And then if a man leaves a woman, okay, come on now, like, let's not be male dominated on this call. Like, stop the madness. Women, we put our all into men. You know, you have babies. That's another stress. That's a lot for women. Like, so, and for someone to completely leave you obliviously, and you got that hanging over your head, and you got to make all these decisions, it could be very stressful, very over-consuming for women. I mean, there's just a lot of factors and things, and it can really blind your judgment, because you got so many things you're thinking about, and you got going on, you're stressed, and I'm just trying to just give you all the factors that this person, they can't even think for themselves, they need help to help them think, because of all the things, weights she has on her. So all I'm saying is I'm just trying to give you another perspective. That's all.
Okay, so why does she have children?
I don't disagree with you.
Why does she
I don't
have
disagree
children?
With you at all.
Why does she have children?
She's a woman. Women have children. Men okay, want to have sex.
So,
women have children.
Irresponsible, like, women, irresponsible women shouldn't have children because now you're putting the children's lives in jeopardy. Stop. You see, some people, some people, Margaret Sanger is necessary for some people. I said it. Some people do not deserve to have children because to me, that is a form of abuse. If you got your children sleeping in a car, right? It's 90 some degrees outside, some days 100, and your children are sleeping in a car, you don't deserve to have children. Put yourself in the children's predicament. They didn't ask to be here. They didn't ask for that. So I don't have no remorse for that. That's bad decision making. When you have three different babies and fathers, three different children, None of them. At what point, S. Marie, does a woman assume some responsibility? Could, I mean, are you not willing? I want to ask you, which part of this equation is she responsible for making bad decisions and choosing these kind of men?
You asking me this question?
S. Marie, that's you, I believe.
I can't answer that question for that lady.
But you, you can know, answer other things. You just answer other things.
You know, we all get out here and date. Like, I'm just a realist. We all get out here and we date. And we pick and choose whoever, just like you do yourself. Everybody has a choice, you know. And you think in the beginning or however that it's a good one, you know. And you wait it out to see. But in the end, you nobody knows the future. You know what I'm saying? So all I'm saying is, there you when you make statements and we live in real life. It's just like you said you never met a real Christian or something. I don't know. I forgot what you said. You said something about a real solid Christian or something like that. I don't know what you said, meant by that. But like who you hang around, like what arenas are you in where you don't meet? Because that's all I ever run into, like you know, solid people. Like, so like you've been like something wrong with where you're going or something. You're not in those environments where you're meeting those styles, because there's some real solid diehard, you know, for God Christians. Like, so like to me, I'm shocked. Like, you know what I'm saying? That you would make a statement like that. Like, but it depends on, like you say, where you at, you know, in your environment, and you're not in those circles. So
what is a Christian? What is a solid Christian?
No, we're not going to do that. You're not going to turn this around on me. I'm just commenting on your statement that you met. And I wondered why. You know, my question to you is why?
Tap dance around.
No, I'm not. I'm being very real with you. You made a statement. So what I'm doing with that statement is asking you the question, just like you're asking me the question. I want to know why you haven't allowed yourself to be in environments with Christians to run into a good one.
Yo, shorty, have some decorum, man. What's wrong with you? Yo, Kahan, go ahead.
No, man, I'm trying to get, I want her to answer the questions. Huh?
Yeah, but she's
making blanket statements.
She needs to keep her emotions in order. Keep your emotions in order and answer the question. You don't got to do all that back and forth yelling.
What is a solid question, S. Marie? So you keep making blanket statements, but none of them you give validity to.
Well, I don't think I'm making blanket statements. You know, okay, I was asking a question. Asking you a question. I know you're asking questions because it's your show, but, you know, at the end of the day, I was asking you one as well, you know, and giving you maybe you haven't been, you know, just making a statement to say maybe you haven't been in those circles where you have had the privilege of meeting people like that. And that's all I'm saying. And maybe you haven't allowed yourself to, because there's plenty of people all around. You know what I'm saying?
So what circle is that?
Maybe you've been limiting yourself from that.
What circle is that?
To me, it's shocking.
What circle is that, sis?
Putting yourself in circles around Christians.
Okay, so I'm asking you, what type of circle is that?
That's going to a Christian church. I don't know. Are you a Christian?
Okay, so we mean a Christian church like TD Jakes?
The way you talk.
You mean a Christian church like TD
Jakes? I'm not going to say anyone, because I'm not for everybody and everybody's not for me. I don't want to say a name. No, I'm not going to say a name or a preacher, because everybody ain't down with all preachers.
You're telling me I don't put myself in these circles. You see what I mean?
No, I didn't say that. Maybe you have.
Yo, you tap dancing, shorty.
Well, have you?
Yeah. I said this.
The question is, have you?
You keep tap dancing around with you're just making hypothetical statements that you cannot give any kind of validity or, you know, stand doing it.
I think you're not trying to see that what I'm saying is valid and very real. You know what I'm saying? Like,
apparently I'm not the only one that has that issue.
No. So
let me ask the sister something.
Go ahead, brother.
He asked you a question for you to give some legit details on that circle that you're speaking of. And you can't give no type of details. Everything that you say is vague, with no type of details that can actually...
Details are going to a Christian church, you know, being around, going to Christian events,
that's a very vague
or conventions
statement.
Or... you know, that's like things like that. That's why I said maybe he hasn't been in those circles, so that therefore he hasn't met those type of people.
That's a very vague statement still. You just saying Christian churches, like you're basically not saying anything by saying go to Christian churches. What Christian churches?
It's just like if you want to be a doctor, you need to hang around doctors. If you want to be a chemist, you need to hang around people who are in chemistry. So if you're a Christian or if you're Muslim, circle yourself around, put yourself in those kind of circles that those people are all about, you know?
Okay.
So that's what I'm saying. So okay, those are not blanket statements. So
are you a so-called Christian?
I'm not judging you. I'm not saying anything. All I said is maybe the reason why you haven't met anyone that's, I don't know what you meant when you made that statement, that we're solid or Christians or something. I forgot what you said. But I said maybe, and I'm not for sure if that's the fact, but like maybe you haven't been in those circles to meet people like that. That's
so
all
then
I said.
How would I be able to give you those names then, sis?
Because they're on TV. Those are people on TV. Everybody knows those people.
It's still been in a circle, right? Right now, we're socializing right now through the internet. I'm not where you are, but we're still socializing.
Okay.
I mean, the internet brings someone right into your home. Do you know that they have thousands of followers on the internet that never attend their churches physically?
Most definitely.
Would you say that they're part of the circle or no?
I don't know. I mean, if that's what they're into, if they're listening
to.
Are
we play that?
I'm saying if that's what you or whoever is listening to. But some people listen to preachers just to find something wrong. You know what I'm saying? Some people, because they're not all about that person or that ministry or whatever, some people look at things or even read the Bible.
Let me explain to you what I was saying, because you've attempted to paraphrase what I stated and was utterly wrong, right? He said that most Christians that he see is a little off track. I stated, is that not what you said, Matt?
I was speaking.
What did you say,
Matt?
It's very simple. What did you say?
I said most, you know, Christian wives will fall off track.
Right. And I say they're not just off track. Every Christian that I met has been derailed, a runaway train. Those are my words exactly. So for you to take that and say, I never met a Christian.
No, I said
vague.
Maybe. I don't know. You know what I'm saying? Now, I said I don't know.
If you could just listen,
just a thought.
If you could just listen, if you could contain your emotions, right? So when I said that's vague, I wasn't meaning I never met one. What I meant is that I never met one that was devout in their belief. There's so much hypocrisy in that. They don't do what the Bible says. So I can't refer to them as a Christian. That derives from the word Christ, right? That's what a Christian is, allegedly, when you bring it over to the Greek. Someone that follows Christ, which means they should be keeping the high holy days, which means they shouldn't be buying and selling on the Sabbath. See, that's what a true Christian is. And when you read the book of Acts, it says that the Christians, the Jews was first called Christians in Antioch, which is Upper Syria. So the Christians are really people that was following the Israelites. They started calling them Jews because Yehuda was the chief tribe. So foreigners started referring to all Israelites as Jews. So when referring to a Christian in the true sense of the word, you're referring to that biblical Israelite. So now, as it spread it out, all people started to refer to themselves as Christians. So that's why I say it's been utterly derailed, because real Christians did what HaMashiach did what Christ did, which was keep the laws, keep the high holy days. That's not happening in church. They don't worship paganistic holidays like Christmas, Thanksgiving, New Year's. They don't do any of that. That's not Christianity. That's paganism. That's Roman Catholicism. Roman Catholicism has nothing to do with the people that follow HaMashiach. Nothing whatsoever. And all forms of Christianity, no matter what they're calling themselves in this world, came out of Roman Catholicism, which is also intertwined with the pagans. This is how you guys ended up worshiping on Sunday. Because Constantine wanted to win the favor of the pagans, and so they came up with worshiping on Sunday, which was the day that the pagans worshiped the moon, and the Christians accepted it. Prior to that, the Christians was worshiping on what? The Shabbat. Why? Because there was Israelites. They were Hebrews. They bought into that. Then they started following Rome. But that's all under Catholicism. So Christianity is all derailed.
Sis, can you at least acknowledge the host point right quick? We're falling completely dead silent.
She's good, huh?
I'm sorry. What was the vibration? Question?
Okay. It is well.
What was the question?
No, never mind. Forgive me. It is well.
Well, to add on to that, based on what the Kahan just said, we don't want to be in any of these Christian circles.
Nope.
We don't.
Con. Yeah. Tazdak, I'm not going to lie. Sometimes I hear you talking. I think maybe you don't know different circumstances and situations and stuff like that. But when you start bringing out your points of view, when you start bringing out facts and truths, things that you've studied from other sources, I start to think, well, maybe he has thought of these things that I haven't thought of. So I just want to say that. There's definitely a lot of times where people could assume, but there is a difference between assumptions and actually, you know, bringing out statistics, facts, and things like that that could actually change the point of view rather than just to think of what could happen.
Now, let me ask you guys.
May I say something? Okay.
Go ahead. No, go ahead. Go ahead.
I guess I don't want to be disrespectful because this is your show, and I only will watch you when you were talking about like being a Secure Party creditor. So that's why I kind of got. I used to watch you, so because I had a situation, and you were like, I liked you. You know what I'm saying? So I never knew you talked about all this. I did see a few of your shows where you talked like this. But at one point you were in a relationship, so I think it's been a lot, but I never knew you like did all this, you know, so, or had these sessions like this. So maybe I came in on the wrong one because I am very much so a Christian. And so I would never want to get on your show and be disrespectful. So it's not my place to go back and forth with you. So I think I'm going to remove myself. So I would just say, you know, in everything, when someone's spitting out knowledge, and this is to anybody in the world, when somebody's spitting out knowledge and history and have read and the Bible says, show yourself to be approved, read for yourself too, you know, and have your own experiences with God. You know what I'm saying? And that's how you gonna know God for yourself. It's through relationship. Because he speaks good. I love the way he's saying, you know, talking about the Most High and all these things, you know, but I'll never sit around arguing with nobody and going back and forth, and I never want to be disrespectful if I do disagree. So that's not my place. But I just say to the young man that just spoke, like, you know, don't let nobody change your perspective, but it's a good thing to know these things, but always go seek for yourself too. Get on your knees, you know, and say, ask God himself these questions so you can have your own relationship, learn his voice for yourself. You know what I'm saying? Have your own personal relationship with God for yourself, because he will enlighten you too. So don't just always go off of someone else. So that's all I wanted to say. I'm gonna be quiet.
Definitely. So I don't believe you really heard what he said. Someone get James 1:19. I think she needs to take this vibration with her. Get James 1:19. This is what probably the undertone of what he was actually saying to you, because you wouldn't listen. You say you don't want to argue. I was trying to create some decorum so we wasn't both talking over each other, but you can. James 1:19.
I apologize.
So, yeah.
Come on, it's James chapter 1, verse 19. Wherefore, my beloved brethren, let every man be swift to hear, slow to speak, and slow to wrath.
Right. So the Christian, the Bible says, be quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to become angry. Well, that's what the scriptures say. So, you know, with that being said, the only thing I was trying to get you to do is to give some sort of support to your statements that you were making. But when I did, you would go to something else. And you said, I'm giving him. And I was trying to show you that you really wasn't. What I was really trying to show you is that sure, things happen, right? Things happen and people could be homeless. And so, but what ultimately happened, when we look at those situations, we always fail to do something in those particular situations. If I end up home, if I know that there's a possibility that I could lose a job, I'm supposed to be planning just in the event if something like that happens. What if disaster strikes? It's not just that person that it happened to. It could happen to millions of more people, because most people are cookie cutters and they do the same thing. It just hasn't happened to them. But what I was trying to point out to people is that if we plan, we could avoid those situations, but we haven't been taught to think that way. We've been taught to live in the moment. We've been taught to go out and get a 9-to-5 and work. And so then I become discontent when they say, we'll land you off, and I end up homeless. But that's a reality that exists that we never consider until it's too late. But if I know if I'm working for someone else and this job, I could walk in tomorrow, hey, we're doing cutbacks, we're doing layoffs, then I'm supposed to be planning for that. That's my responsibility, because I'm setting myself up for homelessness. If I know that I could go out, get in an accident, I could become crippled and possibly homeless, I'm supposed to have some sort of whole life insurance that will cover me for that. A lot of our people don't have life insurance. A lot of people, when they die, the family has to scrape up funds to just have them buried because they don't have life insurance. So I'm saying these things, even though they may come unexpectedly, is because that we fail to plan. We haven't been taught to approach things the way that we should. But if you're listening with emotions, you can't really hear me. That's what he was trying to say. He was initially saying, nah, he's got to be wrong, because she's right. Some things could strike that we didn't plan for. And the reason that it happened is because we failed to plan. But when you look at any of those situations, you can look back and say, is there something that I could have done that could have prevented this? And the answer is usually going to be yes. Whether I've been taught that or not, the answer is usually yes. Because could you picture Donald Trump being homeless? Very unlikely. What? Why? He's planned for things that won't allow that to happen. Think Joe Biden's going to end up homeless? It's very unlikely. The positions that he's been in life is not going to allow that. You can't even fathom that in your mind. But you're saying that it could happen to us. So why could it happen to us? Because you look at us on a different status, a different level, because we haven't been taught to think as they are. But they put on pants just like us. that use the restroom just like us. See, I'm gonna tell you something. There was an event. I'm gonna show you how everyone thinks like everyone else. I think outside of the box. And this is why her and a lot of people have issues with me, right? Because I think differently. I don't think like the general public think, right? 99% of the people think wrong, right? So I was at this one event, right? And there was this long line, and it was an event called How to Think Outside of the Box. So it was literally a seminar that was supposed to teach people to think outside of the box, right? So they called a break. When they called a break, there was this long line reaching all the way down the hallway, people waiting to use the bathroom, right? So I was like, damn, there's got to be another bathroom in this building. This is a pretty big building. So I walked down the hall about 60 seconds later. I found a different bathroom. The bathroom had about 20 empty stalls in it. I'm like, damn, nobody's here. So when I finished using the restroom, I walked back down and told the people online, hey, there's another bathroom right around the corner about 60 seconds away. Don't you know that they stayed right there on the line? No one left. And so that proves my point. And they're at a conference that's supposed to show them to think outside of the box. It's because people do what they see everyone else doing. And that's dangerous. And this is where people stay stuck in life. And when you're trying to bring them something because of cognitive dissonance, they don't hear it. They fight it. And you try and tell them, hey, but there's a different way. Nah, this could happen. That could happen. It's because we failed the plan. We failed the plan. Woulda, coulda, shoulda. And everyone emulates everyone else. But it's only the few people that think outside of the box. You know, the rich becomes rich because they think different than us. They do things differently. They bank differently. Their thoughts are different. We do what we see everyone else doing. Well, everyone else is doing it. Must be right. So they just follow the trend. And so those people stood right there on the line, man. Stood right there on the line because everyone else is doing it. And they were so programmed, they wouldn't walk away. And think about that, Benai. You had a conference, how to think outside of the box.
That's comedy gold.
This is a real life story.
That's crazy.
But it shows you how people notice. Me living in New York, I've seen that more than anything. When someone sees someone does something on a train, everyone starts doing it without even asking. They just follow the leader. They don't stop to think, to ask, well, why am I doing this? If you ask someone, you've seen how many times we had shows about high holy days, and you ask them, well, why do you celebrate Christmas? It's just what my parents did. It's what everyone else did. Well, that's not the reason I do it. So then why are you doing it?
That's a fact.
And when you ask them that, they get quiet. Because everyone else is doing it. So it must be right. But what happens if you see, in that way, we lose our individuality, man. We conform to what everyone else wants us to conform to. So we lose who we really are.
It's a fact. You could apply that to everything growing up. If your parents were Democrats, you're going to be a Democrat. If they're Republicans, you're going to grow up being a Republican. You just apply yourself to whatever you know and are introduced to. That even happened to me earlier today. There was a roadblock headed home, and no one was taking the route to the left. So I looked to the left, and I say, okay, I'll just go this way. And then 3-4 cars start following me. It's like, okay, wow. Yep. I mean, like, you know, people don't really look outside, you know, to see what other solutions are, to see, you know, where the fix is. And to get back to the topic, my poor planning can affect those around me. That's why if I poorly plan and I have children, I'm affecting their lives. I'm putting in danger the lives of my children, and they're going to resent me for that. And they're rightfully so. Imagine being a kid, you growing up because of your parents' improper decision making, you're homeless. You don't have the things you need. Like, of course you're going to be mad. So all those situations that was brought foremost on the table, you know, there's planning to that. You always got to be able to think ahead. People don't play chess with life. They play checkers. They play tic-tac-toe. It's a daily, you know, one step, one step, one step. You got to think ahead. And if you're not doing that, you're really dying. You're really going, because when trouble comes, what are you going to do? You have nothing to fall back on. You have no insurance. You're SOL. But
they keep telling themselves, I'll do it later. I'll get it later. You understand what I'm talking about, Romeo? I'll get it later. I'll do it later. And then it'd be too late.
Gone.
It'd be too late.
And another thing, I think I'm hearing, you know, I heard a lot of excuses from Naive. I'm getting very tired of hearing excuses from people. Because when you start to make plan Bs, you make yourself, you're making a hole within your own plan to say, subconsciously, I don't think I can do this. Subconsciously, I'm going to fail. And when I do, I'll just do this.
Cool.
Stop doing that. Stop making excuses for yourself and other people. You got to hold yourself accountable. And if you fail, you fail, but you keep moving. Plan. The man who plans the most wins the war. Paraphrasing Sun Tzu. If you plan the most, you're going to win. Improper planning, you're going to lose. It's just simple like that. Talking about there's a gray area. There really is no gray area. Things are black and white. Good and evil.
Yeah.
You see that, Matt Too Saucy? You see that, Matt Too Saucy? What did you get from that, Matt Too Saucy? That is your typical Eve, Matt. You see how even she knew in her heart, she got to know that this woman was wrong, right? When I asked her, look how she kept tap dancing. When I asked her, what part do you think that this woman is wrong for making these bad decisions to be with these men? Because she said, oh, yeah, we're women, and, you know, that hits hard. As if it don't hit the guys hard, if not harder, right? Because they're the one that's going to be stuck with child support in 90% of the cases is the guy. You see what I'm saying? So at what point will Eve start to admit that another Eve is wrong and hold her accountable? No accountability, yeah. Even Romeo came on Cecilia tap dancing. He saw it. Everyone could see it. She never addressed the merit of what I was asking her. When I would bring it up, you know what she does with the typical Eve does? I don't want to talk about this. I don't know. We're not going to go there. But you brought it up. You brought it up. But she realizes over here, she's dealing with a man that has a pretty sound mind. And so I'm back by the rule. I never plan what I'm going to say. The Most High just have me speak his will.